help.
Global warming is killing you and me. But what is the main cause of global warming?
What produces more greenhouse gas than all the world's transportation combined?
Methane is 72 times and nitrous oxide is 310 times more potent than carbon dioxide. So who really is the world's largest producer of these greenhouse gases?
What drives one-third of the world's deforestation?
The answer is meat industry.
The survival of the world is in our hands. Be veg, go green, save our planet.
Dr. Robert Goodland, the co-author of the World Watch Institute report that traces at least 51% of global greenhouse gas emissions to livestock raising.
I just had some information just recently that the new figures now indicate that at least half of the greenhouse gases that are up there now, not the 15 or 20%, at least half and maybe considerably more, are due to livestock production.
Well, I think one of the issues is that this huge environmental impact that livestock have is not well understood by the public.
It's not generally known, but between 40 and 50% of all cereals are not eaten by humans, but by livestock. And for soy, that's about 75%.
If you consider that it takes about 7 kilograms of grain, that's corn and soybeans, to just make 1 kilogram of beef, we're talking about hundreds and hundreds of hectares of soy being planted in former rainforest to provide meat.
Like the life cycle of livestock, which may never see a meadow, manufacturing meat faster than the animal has become a daily routine. In these vast food lots trampled by millions of cattle, not a blade of grass grows.
If you eat further down on the food chain rather than animals which have produced many greenhouse gases and used much energy in the process of growing that meat, you can actually make a bigger contribution in that way than just about anything.
As we speak, the human population is increasing rapidly. We have to stop the current trend of meat eating right now in order to stop hydrofluorocarbons released from refrigeration of meat, stop carbon dioxide releases from transporting the meat to the market, the slaughtering process, and transporting the animals to the slaughterhouse. Stop carbon dioxide, methane, and nitrous oxide release from the animals and their waste. Stop carbon dioxide release from plowing, harvesting, and transporting the crops to feed the animals. Stop nitrous oxide release from the fertilizers used for growing the crops. Stop carbon dioxide from burning the trees in the rainforests, cleared to grow food for the animals and for animal grazing. And keep the rainforest to absorb the greenhouse gases in the atmosphere.
It's a win-win situation if you eat less meat.
Living in harmony with the natural world is the only way for the future. 9 billion people, one planet, one chance to get it right.
Go veg, be green, and save our planet.
This video is about us.
We have the power!
Because we can choose not to eat meat.
While it takes decades to change our massive infrastructure of cars and power plants,
going veg is something every person can do every day to effectively combat global warming.
Here are more reasons to go veg.
The committee recognized that the H1N1 pandemic is unstoppable.
According to the World Health Organization, the 2009 swine flu pandemic is the fastest ever spreading pandemic in history, with millions today likely to be infected.
Que es propagada por el puerco y bueno, últimamente ha mutado y se ha evolucionado para ser propagada a través del humano.
Swine flu is far more prevalent in areas with intensive pig production. Canadian agencies have seen a 99% correlation between the number of pig factory farms and the total number of human swine flu cases per province.
When we cram tens of thousands of animals into these cramped, filthy football field-sized sheds to snout atop their own waste, it's just a breeding ground for disease.
The rate of hospitalization and fatality is also higher. In the province of Manitoba, where there are 2.4 times as many pigs as humans, residents are 3 times as likely to be hospitalized and 3.7 times as likely to die from the swine flu than the Canadian average.
Benefits of a vegetarian diet: lower blood pressure, lower cholesterol levels, reduce type 2 diabetes, prevent stroke conditions, reverse atherosclerosis, reduce heart disease risk 50%, reduce heart surgery risk 80%, prevent many forms of cancer, stronger immune system, increase life expectancy up to 15 years, higher IQ.
And animal cruelty, think about it. Follow your logic and your heart.
The images in the following are highly sensitive and may be as disturbing to viewers as they were to us. However, we have to show the truth about animal cruelty.
This is not uncommon. Sometimes they are still alive even after they have been bled and are well on their way down the assembly line to be butchered.
And by dumping struggling and dying steers through metal chutes onto blood-soaked floors, with their breathing tubes and gullets dangling out.
Others may be placed head first in tubes to restrict their movement while they slowly bleed to death.